Hello everyone, so today we're going to go over the Chapter 3 review. We will begin with things you need to know, so this list right here. We have perfect squares and prime factorization, how to square a number with or without a calculator, estimating square roots, and then also, again, using a calculator or also using the perfect squares method. Some application questions, mainly about areas and side lengths and perimeters. We have the Pythagorean relationship, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, and finally some applications of that theorem. Alright, so we're going to go over these six examples here today, starting with number one. So number one is just a list of squares and square roots that you should be familiar with by now. It goes from 1 to 11, so you here have 1 square, 2 square, and so forth down the list, right here. And then what their square values actually are on the right-hand side. And then on the table on the right, same thing, but with square roots. Okay, so on to some examples that we can do. Says here, example 2, determine the area of a square picture with side length 6 centimeters. So that would be 6 centimeters here, 6 centimeters here. And again, this is a square, so these four lengths will be the same size. And all four angles are right angles. So the idea here is that the area, of course, is just going to be 6 squared, which is 36 centimeters squared. Okay, so the opposite kind of question is you're given the area, in this case it's 81 centimeters squared. Again, it is a square, so you have all four lengths being the same size, right angles all around. And of course, the side length, which we'll call either S or L, is going to be equal to the square root of 81. So that, of course, is just going to be 9 centimeters. An alternative question that I could ask is for the perimeter, which is 4 times the length. So in this case, it will be 4 times 9, which is 36 centimeters. Okay. So next up, we have a few questions about prime factorization and estimating square roots. So let's look at the prime factorization of the number 80. Let's see what we get. So 80, we can divide this by 4. Actually, we'll divide by 2 instead. And then we have 40, divide 40, we can divide 40 by 2, we get 20, divide again by 2, we have 10, and then if we divide by 2 again, we have 5. So 2 and 5 are prime numbers, so we are finished with this prime factorization. So 80 is equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 5. Now, you notice that there are 4 2's here, so you can write it as 2 to the 4th power times 5. It is not a perfect square because there's an odd number of 5's. Right, recall that for a number to be a perfect square, it needs to have an even number of each prime factor. So, while it does have an even number of 2's, it has an odd number of 5's. Alright, Next up, we have estimating square roots. So we're going to start with square root of 78. The closest perfect square is 81. And the closest square, perfect square underneath, or below 78, is 64. So we know that the square root of 78 is somewhere between 8 and 9. And then we look at the relative distances between the numbers. It is 14 away from 64 and just 3 away from 81. So it's going to be closer to 9 than it is to 8. And a reasonable estimation will be... approximately 8.8. Okay, next up we have kind of the opposite question. Okay, so we are looking at how many whole numbers have a square root between 8 and 9. So we have 9 and 10, sorry. So we have 9 is less than the square root of some whole number x, which is less than 10. So the square root of 81 is less than square root of x, which is less than the square root of 100. So this will be between 81 to 100. So that means the numbers from 82 to 99 are whole numbers with a square root between 9 and 10. So then if you subtracted these and added 1, because we're counting inclusively, you'll get 18 whole numbers. Okay. The next part will be about the Pythagorean theorem. The first part, of course, is just going to be a squared plus b squared equals c squared. And you can see on the right-hand side, there's a handy right triangle for us to label. So the two legs are a and b, and the hypotenuse is c. Okay. Explain what the Pythagorean theorem means. So this is just a bit of a definition part. So first important fact here is that this, of course, works for right triangles. So for right triangles, the sum of the lengths of the leg squared, so that will be a squared plus b squared, is equal to the length of the hypotenuse squared. That will be c squared. Okay. So that's the meaning of a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So this theorem has a few uses. The first one is to show whether a shape is a right triangle. So we are looking at the triangle inside of there. You notice that in this case we attached the squares already, 101, 36, and 164. So what we're going to do is we're going to substitute in the three numbers. So we have a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So in this case, we have 36. Notice the numbers are already squared. We're not going to square them again. Plus 64 is equal to 101, but that's not true, of course. So, no, not the right triangle. Okay. Let's look at the next example of this. Very similar. Again, we have a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So in this case, we're given the three sides here. We have 5.6 squared plus 4.2 squared. And we're wondering if that's equal to 7 squared. 5.6 squared is, if you use a calculator, 31.36. 4.2 squared is 17.64. And 7 squared, of course, is 49. And if you add together two squares on the left-hand side, you get 49. So 49 is equal to 49. So that's good. So yes, it is a right triangle. Okay, so that's one of the uses of the Pythagorean theorem to show whether a triangle with three given lengths is a right triangle or not. We can, of course, also use the Pythagorean theorem to find lengths of missing sides. It subdivides into two different questions. Either you're given the lengths of two legs, or the lengths of one leg and the hypotenuse. Okay, so the questions are very similar, of course. We do begin with the same theorem. Okay, so in this case, we have a squared plus b squared equals c squared. We substitute in the length of sides. We have 12 squared plus 9 squared is equal to c squared. 12 squared is 144. 9 squared is 81. If you add those two numbers together, you get 225, which is c squared. And the square root of that number is 15. So that's a good answer. Right. Make sure that your numbers make sense. If you're finding the length of a hypotenuse, it should be the longest side of a right triangle. If that's not the case, then something went wrong. Let's look at the second one. So, if you already know that you're looking for the length of one of the legs, what you can do is you can rearrange your Pythagorean theorem beforehand. So instead of a squared plus b squared equals c squared, you can subtract both sides by b squared. So you have a squared is equal to c squared minus b squared. And then we will substitute the values into this. So we have a squared is equal to c is the hypotenuse, so this would be c, and this is the length of the known side. This would be our b here. So we have 14.5 squared minus 12.1 squared. All right, let's see here. We have 14.5 squared is 210.25. 12.1 squared is 146.41. If you subtract those two, then a squared is equal to 63.84. Which is really close to 64. In fact, if you use a calculator for this, and then some rounding, the closest you get to, actually you just get 8.0 meters, because it rounds up from 7.9 and then a bunch of decimal places after that. Okay, so those are the two types of questions that you can be asked when you're looking for lengths of missing sides. Finally, a quick word problem to finish up here. 5 meter long ladder rests against the wall. Now we're assuming that the floor and the wall are right angle, so it's gonna go ahead and draw like this. And then we have ladder. Something that goes this way. Alright, so this would be the 5 meter long ladder. The ladder reaches a distance of 4.1 meters up the wall. We're looking for how far is the base of the wall from the base of the ladder. So we will just call this A, I guess. Alright, so again, we're giving the length of the hypotenuse and one of the legs. So we will begin with the pre-arranged version of the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, so in this case, we have 5 squared minus 4.1 squared is equal to a squared. 5 squared is 25. 4.1 squared is 16.81. It's equal to a squared. We're going to subtract here. So if you take the difference, you have 8.19, which is equal to a squared. And then I'm just going to use this calculator to find an approximate answer for this one. Let's see what we get. We get approximately 2.9 meters. Okay. Looks like the answers make sense. And that's it. So we have covered everything that was in the chapter. The square numbers themselves, right? Knowing the first few of them. And then there's the matter of some applications with square numbers, prime factorization, and whether something is some number is a perfect square or not. And then estimating square roots. And then we move into talking about the Pythagorean theorem, how we can use it to determine if a triangle is a right triangle, and also to determine the length of sides. And that's it for today. Thank you for listening.